Thanks for joining this introductory demo today. My name is Christina Jimenez with the product marketing team here at Coalesce. And today we're going to walk through how to use our next generation data transformation platform. So let's get started. Data transformations are one of the last unsolved challenges in data warehousing. Over time, pretty much every aspect of the data analytics supply chain has become more efficient and automated, especially with the help of best-in-class solutions like Snowflake. But by and large, the transformation process is still highly challenging and manual because of the limitations of both legacy ETL tools and more code-based approaches. Coalesce was born out of this need for a more efficient and scalable way to transform data. And as an automated transformation platform, Coalesce really complements the ease and the simplicity that you see with a modern data stack. Coalesce is the first cloud-native solution that's built for Snowflake and delivered as a service. It empowers data teams to transform data quickly and easily by bringing together the flexibility of code, the efficiency of automation, and the speed of a more intuitive GUI, while giving users the flexibility and control that they need to manage growing projects. In this demo, I'm going to walk you through the Coalesce platform, and we'll take a look at how to build a basic star schema using data in Snowflake. You'll learn how to create a Coalesce trial account with Snowflake Partner Connect, and also the fundamentals of the Coalesce interface. We'll take a look at how to prepare your data for transformations, perform joins and transform multiple columns at once. We'll also take a look at how to build out pipelines more fully and adjust them on the fly. And we'll also take a look at our Git integration and how you can use Git for version control in Coalesce. And finally, we'll also look at how to deploy your pipelines to non-development environments. The data that we'll be using today is the sample TPCH dataset that's preloaded into every Snowflake trial account. And this particular dataset is focused on fictional commercial business data that includes supplier, customer, and orders information. First, we're going to take a look at how to create a Coalesce trial account using Snowflake Partner Connect. Coalesce is built to support full Snowflake functionality, which you'll see in action a little later on. But first, we're going to log into our Snowflake account and then click on Admin in the left navigation bar. Then we'll click on Partner Connect and select the Coalesce tile under the Data Integration section of Partner Connect. And by clicking this Connect button, we're creating a new database, a new warehouse, a user, and a role for our trial account. So we'll receive an email to activate our account, and that will take us right to the Coalesce platform. Once we're in Coalesce, we can launch our workspace of choice from our Workspaces interface. These development workspaces are an important part of Coalesce, and they allow teams to work in parallel on multiple branches in their Git repository. This brings us to our build interface. Now, this is where we'll spend the majority of our time building out our data warehouse. And the graph that you see here represents a SQL pipeline that's transforming raw data. The boxes on the screen represent objects in Snowflake, but in Coalesce, we call them nodes. So as a starting point, let's add some source nodes with raw data into our pipeline. Because we've already set up our account with Partner Connect, you can see that we have our Snowflake sample data here ready for us to use. Let's add some source nodes for our customer, line item, and orders data. We can actually browse the data in detail as Coalesce reads and injects these into our graph. So now that we've added our source nodes, we can start building out our pipeline using a variety of different nodes. Each of these represents a repeatable pattern for building a table or a view in Snowflake. And each node type is coded with different specifications for how that object should be built. So here you can see that we're building a stage node that we can use to preview and perform transformations. You'll notice that this node already has the staging prefix applied because it's inherited the attributes from our source node. Coalesce provides out-of-the-box node types like this one, but it also gives us the ability to build user-defined nodes, which are essentially customized data patterns if we needed to. Every node has the same basic anatomy. So in the center, you'll see our mapping section. And this shows us the structure of our node along with column metadata like transformations, data types, sources, and so on. If we switch over to the join tab in our node, you can see that we can join data from one or many nodes. And we'll do this with the help of a join statement that's generated for us. We can also choose to filter or aggregate our data with other operations, like where clauses, for example. Then to the right is our config section. And so this is where you can view and set configurations for your node based on the type of node that you're already using. And then below, we have our data preview pane, which would show us a preview of our transformation results. All right, let's apply a basic transformation to one of our columns to see how it works. A fun fact about Coalesce is that the platform can manage even the most complex transformations by breaking down data prep into manageable steps. And this is all possible because the platform is built with what we call ColumnAware Architecture, which essentially means that column and table level metadata is used to make transformations more efficient. Once we've added our transformation, we'll press the Create button. And what we're doing here is using the template behind the staging table to create the DDL statement for this node. Now, I mentioned earlier that Coalesce supports full Snowflake functionality. And here we see that the platform has automated the manual side of our transformation for us by generating SQL and then pushing it down into Snowflake. And so what this gives us is standardized best practice code and really an optimized experience for creating our object in Snowflake. By running this node, the DML query is generated from the node template, and then again, Coalesce pushes the code down into Snowflake for us to populate our table. And we can check the results of our node in our data preview pane. Now let's make a few changes to our stage node by deleting the comments column and adding in a join. Now, there are a few ways that we can add in a join. If we wanted to, we could drag in columns from other nodes, and this would generate the join syntax for us. But in this case, we're going to add a where clause. And you can see that Coalesce offers different autocomplete suggestions to help us get this done quickly. We can also validate our SQL to make sure it's correct, or we can make any changes if we need to. Coalesce offers a very thin layer of abstraction on top of Snowflake. So what we're doing is we're generating SQL, we're executing SQL against Snowflake, and then we get our results back directly without any obfuscation. So initially, we created and populated our node. Now what we're doing is we're recreating it and repopulating it with a different schema and a different role. And then down at the bottom, we see our results. All right, before we keep building our pipeline, we want to make sure that our data is good enough to populate into a dimension table. So this is where we're going to lean on Coalesce's built-in testing capabilities so that we can test the quality of our data before it's processed. Now, let's make sure that our customer key is unique and doesn't include any null values. The next time that we would run this node, these tests will be added to the execution of this node, which would fail if the SQL was invalid or if there was a logical failure in the data. And then at that point, we could decide whether to move on through our pipeline or not. Now that we've tested our data, let's build out our dimension node at the end of our pipeline. You'll notice that when we create our dimension node, a standard naming pattern has been automatically added to it, much like with our staging node. But here we have several more options to configure than we did with our stage node. As an example, our stage node just gave us the option of truncating an insert statement. But here, a merge statement will populate this dimension node. But first, let's select our customer key column as our business key. Now, we could just create this node with our business key to create a type 1 dimension, but we want to make this a type 2 dimension. So we're going to select our account balance and market segment columns as specific attributes for change tracking. After we create and run our node, we can take a look at the code that Coalesce has generated for us in order to populate it. Now, this is another great example of how Coalesce's column-aware architecture helps us work as efficiently as possible. You see here that the platform is using column metadata to quickly generate code that's correct and consistent that we needed to build our type 2 dimension. Now, if we take a look at the contents of our node, you'll see that a surrogate key has been added, as well as different system columns to track our changing data. So our start date and our end date are managed for us. And these will flag issues that we would normally have to worry about if we were doing this manually. Coalesce also uses column metadata to provide built-in column level lineage. So this allows us to drill down into any column in any node and see how that data has changed as it's moved through our pipeline. So let's take a look at an example of this. We're going to select our supplier name concat column in our dim supplier node. And if you look really closely, you'll see the split lineage that's created by the concatenation of the two attributes. Of course, this is a pretty small pipeline, but you can appreciate how powerful this is and how powerful it is to have column level lineage if we were working on a massively complex pipeline with tens of thousands of objects. The best part about Coalesce's built-in column lineage capabilities is that it allows us to propagate changes across our pipeline using this column lineage diagram. So, as an example, you can see that our supplier name concat column didn't make it downstream to the rest of our pipeline. But if we just select it along with the nodes that we want to propagate it to, we can add that column to our downstream tables in just a few clicks. Now, let's pretend for a second that our pipeline keeps growing over time, and eventually we're managing a graph that has 10,000 nodes in it. It's going to be a headache to manage a graph of that size unless we have a way of breaking it down into workable sections. And so this is where subgraphs come in handy. We can create mini graphs that contain subsets of nodes that we want to work on at any given time. And Coalesce gives us dynamic filters that will show us these particular nodes as we drag and drop them into our subgraph. So we can actually filter with some of our selector syntax. So we can add a plus sign on either end of our filter to show up or downstream parts of our pipeline. And by using these filters, we can drill down based on the standardized naming conventions that we have for our nodes. Now, depending on how we like to work, we can view our subgraph in either a graphical format or in a more tabular form at the node or at the column level. And this just gives us an extra degree of flexibility, especially if we want to edit columns in bulk. So here we're selecting several attributes in this node, and then we're going to bulk edit them to change the column name. And again, because of how Coalesce is built as a platform, this process is exceptionally efficient. We can really transform our data easily here in bulk and make a change across our entire data warehouse without a lot of effort. At Coalesce, we've seen data teams struggling to perform simple transforms in bulk like this because their solutions just aren't architected to make this as easy as it should be. I mentioned earlier that we were going to talk about our Git integration and how you can use Git in Coalesce for version control. By clicking on the Git icon in our browser tab, we can interact with our Git repository and view all of the objects that we've created since the last time we've committed to Git on this particular branch. So right now we're working on the demo branch, and we have the flexibility to create new branches, merge existing branches together, or we can do conflict resolution all without leaving the platform. When it comes time to deploy our pipeline to a non-development environment, we can switch over to our deploy interface. And so this is where we'll manage the deployment of our pipeline, and we can have as many environments here as we like deployed right from our Git repository. Coalesce makes it extremely straightforward to generate a plan before we deploy any changes so that we can first understand how our changes would affect what's already in production. That's all we have time for today, but if you like what you've seen in this demo, then definitely check out our documentation at docs.coalesce.io so that you can learn more about the topics that we've covered here. Don't forget to sign up for your Coalesce trial account with Snowflake Partner Connect, or you can visit our trial page to start transforming your data today. And of course, if you're interested in seeing a live demo, you can request one from our team on our website at coalesce.io. Thanks for listening in, and we'll see you next time.